Hi, Dad. Happy 60th birthday. Hope you're having a fantastic day and hope you're enjoying the party. It's my turn to tell a story, so I thought I'd share something from my childhood experiences. One of the fishing trips that we went on quite a few when I was younger. This one experience was a little bit different. It was a time that you, Dean, and I decided to go fishing. We had nothing to do one weekend, and we went up to your favorite lake, Lake Mille Lacs. Basically, we stayed at a trailer there that a friend or a relative let us stay at. It was sort of like the ghetto of the area, sort of like a flea bag place. It kept the rain off our head and the mosquitoes out, but that was about it. It was a pretty cruddy place, everything else is really nice, and we were getting a little bit depressed once we saw the place, so you said, "Hey boys, let's go fishing." Great idea. So we jump into your boat. It's a nice little boat, but I just had this feeling about the trip that sort of came over me. I can't explain it, but I just sort of shrugged it off. So basically, we're going in the boat, and we get to the middle of the lake. And, if you're familiar with Lake Mille Lacs, it's a huge, huge lake. And if you get far enough out, you can't see the shore. It makes you very nervous, So basically, we're fishing away, bonding, male bonding, that type of thing. And all of a sudden, I get this feeling coming over me again. And it's hard to explain, but I couldn't quite understand it. I'm asking Dean, he said, "Yeah, I had the same type of feeling, not Dad though, he looks fine." But then I look at the sky and I saw something that made me very, very nervous. There was a storm, Dad. "Can we leave, please, before we die?" And he goes, "No, son." And I said, "Why, Dad?" "Because you're my son, that's why." I said, "Dad, that's not a very good reason to risk my life. I mean, can we leave, please?" He said, "No, let's fish for a while." So it didn't exactly work out. We're still minors, so we're fishing away. He's not very happy, but we try to make a good time of it. And all of a sudden, "This looks like a bad storm, Dad." I go, "Dad, I mean, look at it. It looks like a horrible killer storm." But he said, "Hey, we're on a holiday, guys. Let's have fun. Let's not worry about a little rain, okay?" I go, "Dad, we're your children. Can we please just enjoy this? Where's this guy coming from? I don't know. I gave him too much slack. I guess I didn't stand up to him, but I thought it was a bad storm." But basically, this weird thing happened. It sort of got peaceful all of a sudden, sort of peaceful and quiet, but that was just the moment before the killer storm actually came, because then over the horizon, the clouds just started gushing in. It was terrible. I mean, they were the darkest clouds I've ever seen in my life. And Dad said, "Well, we're not quite ready yet. I mean, we haven't caught enough fish. We haven't caught any by this time." But for some reason, he still keeps going back to the same place. But then the thunder came and the lightning. It was rain at first, but it got bad. Let me tell you, bad as you can find. And all of a sudden, Dad goes, "Maybe we should go in. What do you think?" And Dean and I are already rowing, and this is a speedboat. So basically, Dad says, "Okay, it's time to go in." So we start moving in, And the funny thing about the storm is it kept getting worse, more thunder, more lightning. And, when we started going, we'd go about 10, 20 feet, and the waves would knock us back 5 or 10 feet. I mean, so we're going forward and back the whole time. The boat was rocking. And do you have a picture of what this thing was like? It was a horrible experience, And then we finally get close to the dock. It's about the worst storm I've ever seen in my life. We get to the dock, and Dad's driving. He and I are the ones that have to grab the dock, risk our lives. But finally, we grab it. We rush onto the dock. I said, "Dad, let's get the heck out of here." And, we helped him out of the boat, and we all rushed into the cabin. And I finally felt peaceful for the first time the entire trip. But then, yes, folks, then the word came. "Boys, the boat is getting knocked against the dock. It's getting ruined. I have two sons. I have a few to play with. We have to save the boat." So basically, he makes us put on our rain gear. We rush towards the boat. Basically, the waves are terrible. It's a worse storm than I thought. The waves make the boat go this low. Then the waves knock the boat way up here. We're trying to get on the dock. It's one of the most miserable experiences I've ever had in my life. And Dad, I haven't gone fishing with you since, except for one time. We did try going one time, and it rained the entire time. I spent the whole time in a coffee shop. I must have had about 40 donuts that weekend. It wasn't the most
want to say happy 60th birthday, and the thing that I remember, a vivid memory about you, is when you brought us up from Nebraska when we were first moving up here, and it was raining, and didn't have a top for the trailer, and we stayed overnight in, where was it?
Lamar's, Iowa.
Stayed overnight in Lamar's, Iowa on Halloween night.
What's Lamar's Island?
Iowa.
Lamar's, Iowa?
Say something about the trip and the wipers.
No.
Yeah, tell us about the wipers. The
wipers were broken.
Oh, no.
Had a scar. As we were going up in the rain, but it pulled over every 5 or 10 miles.
Really?
To let the rain, you know.
Did it take you a long time to get up here then?
Yeah.
And he shows, I gotta wait.
Well, when you're nervous or something like that,
what?
So that's why you pulled over every 10 miles, because you got nervous or something?
Dad.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It was the rain.
Well, we got a couple questions we're asking people. How well do you know your grandfather? What's his favorite color?
Blue.
Blue? What's his favorite food?
That he can eat or that he does eat?
Either one.
Chicken.
Chicken. What's his favorite TV show?
Anything that has to do with sports.
Okay, what's his favorite sport?
Football.
Now, if you had to pick one embarrassing moment, what would you say it would be? You in front of your grandfather or him in front of you?
I don't understand that.
Any embarrassing moment that you can think of?
Not
really. Okay. Yeah, one more thing to say. What do you want to say?
Happy 60th birthday.
Get it.
feel to be 60? Pretty good, huh? Well, as you know, Merck and I just got back from vacation. We went out to California, out to visit Martian Steve, and did a lot of fun touristy things. And this vacation, I have to say, went a lot better than last year's vacation. As you may remember, last year we took a vacation down through Omaha, saw Mike and Joan, and went on down to Texas. And as you might remember, down in Texas, I got sick. So sick that I stayed house-ridden for the entire visit. So we didn't get to do any sightseeing, we didn't buy any souvenirs, anything like that. Well, as we were driving home, we were going to be stopping through Austin, and it was your birthday. Well, we had intended to get you a birthday present down in Texas, but that didn't work out. So we stopped at the mall in Austin there, and we were looking around, looking and looking for something to get you for your birthday. Well, as people probably mentioned to you before, you're not the easiest person to shop for, so we were looking and looking, had no clue what to get you. All of a sudden, we came across these Bart Simpson t-shirts. We thought it'd be great. Bart Simpson was pretty popular at the time. We thought you'd love it. So we picked up a Bart Simpson t-shirt, brought it over to your house. Well, you were in the house when we got there. Betty was sitting out on the lawn. So we told her ahead of time what we were getting you. She busted up laughing. She just thought that was the funniest thing. As it turns out, you don't like Bart Simpson. In fact, the t-shirt said, "Hey, don't have a cow, man." As it had turned out, Jody said this to you all the time, and you hated it. Well, anyway, we thought this was going to be pretty funny now. So anyway, we give you the birthday present, you open it up. You were left rather speechless, I have to say, but you were chuckling about it. Well, needless to say, Betty, Mark, and I were all getting a pretty good laugh out of this. But you were a pretty good sport. You tried it on, paraded it around, and you looked pretty darn good in it, too. I hope you still have it. I hope you still wear it. Like I say, it looked pretty darn good on you, but I think that's one of the best gifts we've ever gotten for you. It's just a little story I thought I'd share with you and remind you about. Hope you're having a happy birthday, Les.
Happy birthday, Dad. Happy birthday, Dad. Happy birthday, Dad. Happy birthday, Dad. Happy birthday, Dad.
Okay, now it's your husband's 60th birthday. Mm-hmm. What do you want to say to him, Betty?
Well, you don't think I'm going to wish him a happy birthday?
No, I want you to wish him a happy birthday in the camera.
No, I'm not going to do that.
Do you believe, like the Hindus, that this sort of captures your soul, a little piece of it or something like that?
Because
basically, who said the same type of thing?
Who said the same thing?
No, I'll do this to you all day today. Come on.
Hi. And?
Hi, Betty.
Probably when we're about halfway there, I think. Because we
doll with him. Do something fun then. Do something fun then.
They swing through the air. I don't know, do they have a net? Yeah, they do.
They
you know, it's a nice place to gamble. It's a nice place to eat. I mean, there's nothing wrong. It's a nice place.
They have a really nice buffet.
It's just, if you don't know your way around there, it's circus, I think most people, you know, do stop there.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
People that are traveling or in motorhomes or...
So, Betty, do you like Reno or Vegas better?
I don't know.
You don't know?
All yours.
Happy 60th birthday, Dad. My story is back to about the time when I was 15, and I believe you were in between marriages. And used to go out of town on weekends. And so every Friday night, if the front light was on, I used to always have a party at the house. Well, one Friday night, I wasn't so lucky, and two guys decided to fight, and they fell on the maple table and ended up on the floor. And I was really fortunate that you didn't come home and try to hit me with one of the legs of the table. But that did end the parties, unfortunately.
So how long did this go on?
What, the parties?
The parties.
Four or five months.
4 or 5 months?
Yeah.
What time
Happy
of year?
Birthday, Les.
What time of year was it?
I don't remember.
You don't remember what time of year it was?
No, not at all.
The winter time.
Yeah.
60 years old? You must have been serving wine at the Last Supper. 60! You know, your daughter said a little while ago, not to put it on tape, that you didn't think you didn't think you'd probably live to be 60. Not many people do live to be that old, Les. My God.
He should be very happy.
Once you notice, Les, the pool, here we are, it's summertime, 8:30 at night. In the summer, Les, not the winter, California. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Jake, Jenny, Jody, and I, we were all downstairs talking about bar hopping.
birthday. We hope you have fun with your family and friends. Wish you could be there.
Hope you get some great presents.
And remember, my birthday's coming up.
So, Dad, I'm sorry, I gotta sit like this. Okay, I'm gonna stand up now. Are you You ready?
You can stand up?
Yeah.
Okay, go for it, Bruce.
Going up.
Going up.
Thank you. So after a few moments, I finally got out of the water. And can you sit down and be caught in the camera here, do you think?
Yeah, close enough.
Well, I'll see him, make sure you just hold on. Actually, this will work just great because it looks like you're a little kid and I'm a father. So Mike had just pulled me out of the water. He finally got his hand on me, and then my head was bobbing above the water, and I looked up and here's my father, and he just racing, and he was like, it was like a 20-foot path, and I swear you only touched it 3 times. You were screaming down there. You get me out of the water, and I'm standing there, and you go, Are you all right?
Yes.
And that's what I said. I said, yeah, I'm fine, Daddy. That was a horrible experience. Are you okay, son?
Yes, I am.
Oh, you scared me.
Why are you so close to the water, though?
And that was love, Pop. Thank you. That's all there was to it.
You betcha.
I appreciate that. My
second starring role.
I brought my phone.
Yeah.
That Mark's mistake right there, by the way. And again, this is going to be unedited, correct?
Unedited. Live and up close.
That's right.
Personal.
I've always wanted Mary Hart. Isn't that woman on that one show with the legs?
You always wanted her?
I always wanted her to interview me.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, but I'm married now. I'm wearing my ring. Can you see my ring?
I can see it.
Can you do a close-up?
It glitters.
Does it?
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty cool. Anyway, a couple more things about Dad. Does anybody remember the peach? I'm sure everybody in my family will be watching. Do you remember the peach cake? Oh, you were probably
teaching. Peach cake, nope.
The peach cake story. That's a fun story for me to tell to this day. When we were all sitting around the table, and I thought it cheap that I only got one little small piece of peach cake, and I made some comment like, you know, what are we, a poor family? We can't have as much cake as we want, something. I was on a Sunday afternoon at about noon, if I recall, and Dad, being a generous individual that he was, allowed me to sit by myself uninterrupted and requested that I sit there and finish the rest of the cake, which was, you know, one of those large pans. And I think it was like 3.5 hours later. I had devoured a good piece of it, but I was at that time getting a little sick. So I got my wish, and again, a loving father, I thought that was quite generous. And I'm trying to think, there's a lot of things I could say, Dad, but I guess the one thing is the last one would be the Elvis haircuts. I used to love the Elvis haircuts. That was when you were either going to be a meat packer for a living, or you're going to get into the hair design business or hairstyling business. You used to take, actually, I remember Mark, I remember yours was the funniest of all. You used to take
the bowl cut.
You do that, all hair, well, this actually did to me and Mark, but he'd get our hair pulled straight down like this, and he'd cut it. Start here, and he just cut it like at a 45-degree angle, and just cut it across, and the idea was you're supposed to take it and whip it back. I remember the first time he did that to me, and I went to school that day at Central. I was still going to Central Lutheran, and I walked around, I don't know, I was like in the fifth or sixth grade, fourth grade or whatever. I remember walking around for a good part of the day with my hands like this. I'd walk around like this, and everybody was asking me what my problem was, and I said, you wouldn't understand it. It was my father and his Vidal Sassoon dream. But what else can I tell our viewers about here? I guess that's really it, Pop. You know, I would like to summarize, or just say one more thing. I guess I would have liked to have a lot of things different in my life, in my childhood. I would have loved to have had things be more what I wanted them to be. If you read Calvin and Hobbes, the comic strip, it's about a little boy who's like 6 years old and he doesn't understand why he never gets what he wants. And the whole premise of the cartoon is he talks to his stuffed tiger, who is a cartoon character, and they can converse back and forth. But anyway, Calvin always wants everything his way. And I guess I would have liked to have had a lot of things different in my life. But now that I'm 33 years old and I think about how my life has been, I really wouldn't have changed anything. As a matter of fact, if nothing else, I feel myself quite fortunate because although there are things that I think everybody in my family has done that I've disagreed with, and certainly I've done a lot of things that everybody else has disagreed with, I've always felt a genuine love from you. And right or wrong, you know, obviously everybody's going to be incorrect at times. I think just the fact that I always knew you loved me got me through a lot of times that could have otherwise been very detrimental to my health. I've done some stupid things in my life. I'm sure I'll do even a few more, but I think for the most part I've turned out to be a pretty good person, and I really owe a lot of that to you, and I guess I love you, obviously. And I hope you had a great 60th birthday. I look forward to you parting with me on my 60th birthday. There will be alcohol served at my 60th birthday, by the way. By that time, James, when you see this, you'll be... James is how old now? About
13,
14.
Something like that.
So when I'm 60 years old, about 28 years, you'll be a drinking age then, James. So you and I will have a couple beers at my birthday, and we'll have a good time. But I guess that's it. I've said enough. I hope you're having a great day today. He'll be watching this on...
The party.
Okay. So happy birthday, Pop. I hope you have a great one. And I'm sure everybody's getting tired of listening to all this stuff. So I'll end it there. That's all I got to say. Peace. We'll be right back.
It's Ian's birthday, Dad. I'm supposed to think of a story.
Make me sound like a slave driver here.
Sorry. there's so many stories, I can't pick out which one I'd like to use. I guess what I remember most from my childhood, I don't know about this, Mark.
From your childhood?
I can remember you when you used to get on Prince and try and get him to go forward, and you'd use up the reins on him and slap him on the rear end, trying to get him to go forward, and he would back up so fast that you would fall over with him onto the side of the road, and I guess that sticks out a lot in my mind.
Now, Prince was the white horse, wasn't
Prince
he?
Prince was the white horse. He's the first one we ever had.
First one we ever had?
What about the one where he was riding his water scooter?
Well,
he out back up.
I don't know if I saw him do that or not.
It was funny anyway. How many horses did you guys have? It was like three, wasn't it? Like Corky, Prince,
and Joe?
Okay. Did he give you all those at the same time, pretty much?
Well, no.
Not really?
No, he got Prince, and then maybe like a year or so later, he saw Corky and Don Wilson's pasture, and Corky was pretty, so he bought him.
Was there one time, it was about a few years ago, you were going to a horse show with him or something like that, and he didn't really care for it? What was that about?
Oh, you should ask Bruce about that. Bruce and I think it was last year, around Father's Day, we thought we'd spend some quality time with Dad.
Mm-hmm.
So we
quality time.
So we invited him and Betty to a horse show. And
oh, that's the one I went to.
Yeah, Nick was there too. And we got there, and Dad thought it was going to be inside the Cream Pavilion, but it was outside.
Mm-hmm.
And then it was windy, and it was dusty. So I think Dad sat outside with us for maybe like 5 minutes.
And then he got inside the car.
And then he said, well, I think it was windy or dusty, so he went and got the car and then sat in the car about maybe 10 feet away from me and Bruce.
Mm-hmm.
And then pretty soon Betty was in the car with Dad.
Mm-hmm.
I think we were there a total of 15 minutes. So
is that your idea of quality time?
Well, I guess, yeah. Bruce and I both commented, and it was well-spent quality time.
That was cute. Okay, well, ask just a couple of questions here. What's his favorite color?
Well, I asked Betty that a few weeks ago, and I think she said black, I think.
Black? Favorite food?
It's gotta be something I can't eat. Sweets?
Okay. Favorite TV show?
TV show. Wheel of Fortune, Nick, is that the one he's always watching? I think
Inspector Gadget, he watches that on Nickelodeon every
day. No, I'm talking about the game show.
He does. Really?
He
watches that on Nickelodeon every day.
Never heard of that show.
It's cartoon.
Can you think of one embarrassing moment around Pop? You embarrassed from him, or him embarrassed in front of you?
Well, I know whenever we're in a restaurant and has his sunglasses on for the first 20 or 30 minutes, that's embarrassing.
Okay, don't do that anymore, Pop.
He's still got his coat on, too.
Okay, say one more thing.
Happy birthday, Dad.
else you want to say?
What else you want to say?
Nothing.
Anything else? Okay. Why don't you want to say what you want to say when you're ready?
We're going to say it together or separately?
Together.
Who's going to count?
Mark.
Okay, Kathy will count.
What do we say?
Out loud, okay, so they can hear.
Happy 60th birthday.
Yeah, and when do we say? When you get to three or
when
ten?
I get to three.
Okay.
Okay.
Happy 60th birthday.
Nick, you missed the cue.
Yeah,
we
did.
We'll have to do it again.
Get it right.
Okay. There you go. Okay.
Can't wait a second though.
Oh.
Give her give her the sign.
Okay.
Make sure to say it.
Okay.
Happy 60th birthday.
Okay. What enthusiasm! couple of minutes, so.
Say anything you want to say.
Say what we want to say.
Say happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Les.
Happy birthday, Les. I hope you can get to fish with me a little more. Yeah. A surprise.
I've never caught a fish with a man yet.
Haven't you really?
Did he just got a big one?
He went with me one time. We got, well, fed up with the bugs, but he had a good time.
Did he?
We went to Lost Lake and he had a good time.
Morris? He just got a 9-pounder.
He got a 9-pounder?
That's a fable. He bought it at a store somewhere.
Really? Really? What length did he go?
The time that he came home late and he had the car in the ditch and I had to scrape the blood and stuff off the box.
That's a good start, though.
Huh?
That's a good start.
I think I'll quit right off.
We like those details.
Oh, yeah.
face paint?
Meant to you.
Meant pure hell.
We're not talking about your kids, we're talking about my paint.
Here, 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 here is where we get our attitude, right?
Keeps going. Well, what can I say?
Well, elaborate more, I guess.
Yeah, just say, say where it comes to your head, Pop.
Start from
let's
where
have positive.
Record for posterity, Pop.
Let's have some positive.
When you see this, it says over the hill and flying high, I guess, what is that? Well, I guess it says it all, doesn't it?
Hey, what you ought to do, Les, is have them kids bring that camcorder up when we go fishing in September.
Watch yeah, we want
there you go. Tell us about actually catching a fish.
Big bass.
That's yours,
I really
you're
a
little shy.
I bet you're
a
little shy.
friend is a brain.
Might be looking for somebody next week.
You did?
Yeah,
we're going
to go.
I used to be a VP.
I didn't know.
Mm-hmm.
Lindsay, is it time to eat?
Because I just missed the West Coast.
I'm going to eat right now.
Good boy!
Say hi!
only a big difference. You should be proud of.
That'd be an exciting response, huh? No more caffeine for you.
Go get him a pillow and watch his face when he cries.
I'll never get to the one coming, I guess.
He's on the kill. Kick him.
Just like you got, huh?
Dad, we're all used to it. Nobody's saying math.
Garbage can out.
It is
a new mic.